Herman, when you ready?
I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, 50 years, the bathrooms are out to the exit. If you're anything like me, when you gotta go, you gotta go, you gotta go right now. So let's get ready, the bathrooms are straight out. 50 years. 50 years. Where did time go? When I was younger, my old man, we still got a service station. When somebody would come over there and tell me that they are going to their 50th class reunion, I would look at them up and down and say, oh my goodness, are they still walking? Are they still breathing? Are they still talking? Most of all, are they still boom booming? DJ Hitman! Gentlemen, this is what it's all about. Our 50th class reunion tonight. And hopefully everything will be right. And we're going to do it like it needs to be did. Because this is a time to have fun. And this is what it's all about this way. Oh, yeah. Get it on tonight. I don't forgot the words to this song, but I don't know what it be. But either way with me, this is what it's all about tonight. All right, DJ, cut it. Coming to the stage at this time. Young lady 50 years ago was Diane Dyson. Today, she is Mrs. Diane Dyson. Higgy! Diane, come on with me, DD. Let the people know what it's all about tonight and what you got to say. Would you like the handheld or the stationary?
Good evening. It is so nice to be here.
DD, Diane Dyson Higgy. Right now, let me do something for y'all. I got a little joke for y'all. I'm gonna need my jacket for this. Check, check. Check, check, okay. A little while ago, a buddy of mine went to buy a new suit. Went in and got fitted up, looking real good. Left out, walking down the street, saw a couple of friends of his. He said, fellas, how y'all doing? How y'all like my new suit? His friend said, hey man, the suit is you, but you got a problem. He said, what? One of your sleeves are longer than the other. He said, went back, man, you sold me the suit and one of the sleeves. He said, hey, hold up, bro, ain't no problem. Just take your sleeve, pull it up, tuck it. You're all right. Walking down the street, saw a couple of more friends coming back. I said, fellas, how y'all doing? He said, hey, man, how y'all like my new suit? I said, the suit is you, but you got a problem. He said, what? One of the little pails are lower than the other. He said, went back to the man, said, man, you sold me the suit a little pail. He said, no, man, hold, bro, you ain't got no problem. Just take your little pail, pull it up, tuck it under your chin. You all right? Walking down the street, saw a buddy of his and everything. He said, but hey, fellas, what y'all doing? How y'all like my new suit? The man said, hey, suit is you, but you got a problem. He said, what? One pants leg longer than the other. Went back to the man and said, man, you sold me the new suit, the sleeve, the lapel, everything. He said, hold up, bro, you ain't got no problem. Take your pants leg, pull it up, tuck it. You all right? Hey, we're walking down the street like this. Two nuns come walking up the street, and one nun say, look at us and say, ain't that pitiful? But the other nun say, yeah, but that suit sure is fitting him, though. DJ, hit it! Yeah, all right. 67, we're funky. In 67, we had soul. We had a doggone beef, and we took care of business too. In 67 we rock, in 67 we roll. In 67 we had a whole lot of soul. And yeah, we were funky then, and we funky now. Even though some of us have gone down, we are still around. And that's why we're here tonight, to make things right, out of sight. And that's the way it's gonna be, y'all with me, just to see what we gonna do. DJ Cut It, coming to the stage. 50 years ago, this young lady was Dolores Perry. But at this time, she is Dolores Perry Ward Smith. Dolores Smith Ward Perry, what all these names are. Come on up and tell the people what you gonna do and what it's about tonight. Because hopefully, we're gonna get things going, you know, because we're gonna eat in a little while, and we're gonna get things running. Dolores Perry Ward Smith.
Good evening,
A few tidbits that y'all just might want to know about. In 1967, the cost of a stamp, 5 cents. Gasoline, which we sold, was 33 cents a gallon. A movie ticket was $1.25. Federal minimum wage was $1.40. I know when I finished high school, I got a job at Brown and Williamson Tobacco Company in 1970. I was making $2.40 an hour. I be pumping gas, and a lady came from this campus over there. I'm real close to the campus, you know. And she said, Rocky, you didn't want to go to school? You didn't want to do it? I said, well, yeah, but by the time I finish, I'm going to be making $5 an hour. And she said, you don't make no $5 nowhere. I left there in 1982 making $12.50 an hour. Average cost of a new car, $2,750. Popular movies back then, The Graduate, Bonnie and Clyde. Guess who's coming to dinner, Sidney Poitier. And guess who's coming to dinner, Sidney Poitier. And In the Heat of the Night, Sidney Poitier. And Cool and Luke. Just a few tidbits to let y'all know what's going on. Most popular TV shows back then, which I still watch today. Every evening when I get an opportunity, I go home to see who? The Andy Griffin Show, Bonnie Fife and all. The Lucy Show, Gomer Pyle, Gunsmoke, what we all can relate to. Family Affair, Bonanza. The Red Skelton Show. I saw Red Skelton the other night, and let me tell you, Red Skelton is one that we always enjoy. The Dean Martin Show, the Jackie Gleason Show, and last but not least, the Twitch of That Nose, Bewitched. A couple of quotes, memorable quotes. We have here a failure of communication. Anybody know what movie they came? Cool Hand Luke is just moving. Cool, it was it. Cool Hand Luke is right. Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me, aren't you? The Graduate, okay? They call me Mr. Tibbs. Yeah, Sidney Poitier in The Heat of the Night. Oh, by the way, Kenny Massey told me Diane Dyson and Alan Clark, I got $5 apiece from last night. Those questions, Diane Dyson, the smartest one in school. And she answered some questions last night that didn't nobody know. But moving right along, the invocation and the blessing, because I thought we hungry right now, we got to move this along. Coming to the stage at this time, Lawrence Kenny Massey. Oh, you can't, man. You know you can't walk without that cane. Stop playing, man. I'm trying to show off. Oh, bathrooms are straight in the back, okay?
I made sure I took time to place this in writing because normally I go 25 or 30 minutes.
Check. Now, you see how Lawrence came up and what he said was so nice and quiet? And it brought a tear to everybody's eye. But that ain't me! But you better believe that it's time to to eat. It's time to feed your faith in this place. So everybody just stand around, sit around, and go get what you need in order to soothe that hungry. I done told y'all, bathrooms are straight in the back.
We are the old people now. And every morning we get up out of our bed and stand vertically. We need to thank God for that. And let's enjoy every day we got here. And let's live every day like it's the last of our time. So do what we got to do and do it fast so everybody can have a real...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are back one more time and we're going to tell everybody what's on my mind. Moving right along. Little bit of trivia from back in the day. The best place to buy a hot dog or hamburger after church on Sundays. J&B restaurant. Where the cool guys shopped for their clothing. Cool guys. Levinson, that's right. Andrew Wyatt was over the service station today. Name three movie theaters that were near the Halifax Street Triangle. Jim Theater, The Bug House, and Barney's. Y'all remember Barney's? First black mayor in Petersburg, Fauntleroy, that's what we're talking about. This florist shop on St. Matthew Street and owned by the family of one of our classmates, Sue's Florist. The place to go after hours to find friends and a quick meal delivered to your car. Mike's, that's what I'm talking about. We spent many times right down at Mike's. If you leave your lights on, the young lady will come to your car, take your order, and bring it back. The name of the upscale department store located downtown on Sycamore Street. Rucker or Rosenstock. Name the two sets of twins in the 67 class. The Valentines and the Wells. How many people in here went to Blanford Elementary School? Blanford, and that was from what year to what year? From the first grade to something. Virginia Avenue. Hey, that's what we're talking about, Ginger Avenue. Giles B. Cook. Ah, that me too, me too. But from Giles B. Cook, then Westview was built. And in the third grade, a lot of people transferred to Westview. How many social clubs was in our class in 90? I was a member of the Coat Social Club. Over here, name me one, give me one. The Alphas, give me one. I noticed a young lady was talking last night about the Mustangs, the Oasis. Anybody we left out? I can't hear you, but anyhow, we got some more in there, all right? All right. Moving right along. Coming to the stage at this time. Young lady 50 years ago was who? Arlene LaSaint. She's been this name for a long time. It's Arlene LaSaint
and the son Ali Hussein married to Othello. I don't know how many years it has been, but they are still doing what they do. Come on up, Arlene, and tell the crowd what it's all about. I don't know what you're gonna say, but come on up here and say it anyway. Arlene Hussein, yeah, let's get along. Get it right. Ali Hussein, ladies and gentlemen, but most of all, Alan Clark. Let's give him one more hand because he still got what it takes to get it through, and he did what he do. All right, Al. This song right here, The Supremes, was one of the top songs in 1967. Every talent show that we had, every young lady that was able to sing and could sing, you better believe that she wanted to be one of the Diana Ross or one of the Supremes. Ladies and gentlemen, I was on my way to work the other morning and came on Tom Joyner morning show, and he said in 1967 the next guy that I'm about to introduce, it had a top-rated song. This song was made for the Vietnam War, for the racial unrest in America. This song was supposed to have been sung and given to Tony Bennett, but they decided to give it to none other than our own Louis Satchmo Armstrong.
I see trees of green,
I love that song. Let it play.
For me and you,
and I think to myself, what a wonderful day. Oh yeah,
I see skies.
Cut it. Get him ass. Come here a minute, Kenny.
All right, now, y'all take it in. Something happened to me earlier, that's right.
Thanks. I know we pressed, but time, we will. What you doing?
I promised Rock I was going to do something, but I told him since I'm in the ministry now, I can't go back to what I used to do. And there's some songs that make me do things that I say I wouldn't do anymore, so Rock, I decided not to do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we had something planned, but unfortunately for Kenny, it's not going to happen. But back in 1967, we had the Senior Future Reunion.
Don't go there.
And it was at the Coconut Grove, a setting that 20 years from then, people would walk in and what they would be then. But back then, the teachers wouldn't allow you to play certain songs. Certain songs was a taboo. But tonight, we gonna bring it to you, and that certain song, DJ, hit it. And if y'all can remember, when that song came out, somebody jumped up out of their seat, ran up on the stage, here on fucking Broadway. The teachers, they closed the curtain, and they went outside the curtain, and they did the fucking Broadway. Turn it up! A taboo back then, but it's mediocre right now. Cut it! Calm down. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we have 50 years ago, Wilhelmina Green.
Now she is Wilhelmina Green Hales. And along with her, Bert Parham the third. Please come forward. I ain't know Bert Parham was the third. Anybody knew Bert Parham was the third? Bert, you, it's three of y'all. Parham the third on this sheet right here. Come on up. Wilhelmina Green back then was voted the shortest in the class.
She didn't get no trouble.
Come on in. Come on up. Ladies and gentlemen, tribute to the deceased classmates. Team 67, Aretha Franklin, R-E-S-P-E-C-T, and she brought it your way that time, the Queen of Soul, the number one song in 1967. Oh yeah, something that we don't even get today. I got a store next to me and the young kids now, if you walk up in the store, you don't get no respect. Where has time gone and 50 years ago? You didn't show respect to somebody, you got a whipping in school. You got another whipping when you got home, and everybody just tore your behind up. Time out. Yeah, you got that time out all right. Moving right along. DJ, cut it. Coming to the stage at this time, 50 years ago, Sylvia Wilson. Today, Sylvia Wilson, but AKA Lee Lee. Lee Lee, Lee Lee. Come on up here, girl, and let's see what you're talking about. I had a little something to say about most of those young ladies right there. Bertha Bailey. E pluribus unum et tu brute. I remember back then when our final exam, I knew every question on that final exam in Latin, but two answers. The king of Thrace and the carnivorous birds of some Allen. And I didn't know the answer, so the king of Thrace, I wrote down Brian Johnson. Just to be funny. The carnivorous birds of whatever Allen that was, I wrote down Eager Eaters. Two questions that I didn't know, and Bertha Bailey was grading that final exam. Mr. Bates, king of Thrace, Brian Johnson, the carnivorous birds of something, Eager Eaters, zero. I said, oh, Lord. But I still passed the class. Evelyn Hollins, como está usted? Muy bien, gracias. Uy usted, lo siento mucho. Cuídese bien. ¿A qué hora es? But most of all, I remember the statement, Mr. Bates, el burro is smarter than you. Geraldine Macklin. A car connoisseur. Geraldine Macklin had a 65 Mustang that she drove for years. She loved cars. At this time, I have a 1989 Buick Riata. They only made a few of them, more along, you keep it the more it's worth. But one day, me and a friend of mine rode through Colonia Heights up the boulevard to Burger King. Riata clean as a pin, you understand it? Got out, cleared ourselves, walked in, and there sit Geraldine Macklin. Mr. Bates, is that your car out there? I said, yes, ma'am, Miss Macklin, how you doing? That is one beautiful automobile. And gave me that eye. I said, Geraldine, yeah. All right. Moving right along. I got a piece of paper up here somewhere. Who got the paper? Who? Lily got my paper. What? Do you need? I got it. Girl, I done found it. Time has gone by mighty fast, but we must end this because we got the band to play. DJ, give me a little bass on those 88s. Ladies and gentlemen, with us at this time, if y'all can remember back in the day this record came out, And we have the man here with us tonight, the individual that sung on this song, the bass player himself. That's right, the Boogie Doctor. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for us being here tonight. 50 years have still here. We still pumping strong. We still moving along. And hopefully everything will be all right. And we can make what we need to do to get it through with me, Rock Bates, the mouth of the South.